This mini split inverter AC is working, and the PCB control board is also functioning. The LED 101 blinks once for 1 second, which is its normal condition. I heard the compressor sound, and suddenly the LED 101 started to blink faster, 2 to 3 times in 1 second. The light blinks 66 times, then the unit control board starts working in normal condition. The display is showing a P4 error. And see, the display got normal after some time. Now the outdoor fan has also stopped. The unit has been working for half an hour now. The P4 is a compressor drive error mentioned in the company's manual. This means that when the compressor does not start, the PCB control board gets unable to detect it. Then it will show the P4 error. Now I will tell you the possible faults in this mini split. The control board could also be faulty when the IPM gets bad from its high voltage pins or the low voltage pins. If any resistor in the way of the IPM burns, which would not be connected in the way of the microcontroller, as some parts are not connected to the microcontroller, due to which it shows no error. If the compressor does not start, it will show the P4 error. One connector of the compressor is attached here with the PCB, and the other is attached to the compressor. If the connection of the compressor wires gets loose or if any wire cuts out, the wires of the compressor are installed beneath this protective cover. As the compressor heats, sometimes the wires also heat up and disconnect. The other reason is if the compressor itself gets bad, the winding of the compressor can get bad. Or the pump gets jammed, which is installed inside the compressor. Still, the P4 error will be shown. I think the faults I told you, one of them could be present in this mini split unit. And whether this mini split is repairable or not. Now I have removed the PCB board and checked it without electricity. The IPM is fine. I will now pass electricity now and make you test its voltages across the IPM. Let me plug in the electric switch. As I passed electricity, the LED light started to blink. I am checking the DC voltages. These are the negative pins, and this is the positive pin. We are getting 294 DC volts here. The electricity in my place is low, that's why we are getting low volts on the IPM, as normally the volts on these pins are above 300. We are getting 14 volts on the first pin of the U, V, and W. The second pin has 14.75 volts. The last pin also has 14 volts. The high side of the IPM is okay. Now I have attached analyzer with the PCB board to check it. The light is also blinking. I have attached the analyzer in place of this connector. The analyzer tests how many IGBTs are turning on and how many are turned off. Now you see all the IGBTs turned on the PCB board. No IGBT was off. It means that the control board is fine. It has no such issue. Next, I will test the compressor connections and check its wires. I have already tested the wires and their connection, whether any wire is cut. I didn't find such an issue. Now I will check this connector which is installed with the compressor. I have set the multimeter to ohmmeter. First of all, I will test its winding. I have attached the red probe with one of the connector terminals. And I am attaching the black probe with any other connector wire. The multimeter is showing no values, which is surprising. Let me check the meter by attaching the red with the black probe. It is okay. The value showed and disappeared. Now, let's check with the next terminal. No reading with this terminal as well. So it is not showing the ohms reading with any terminal of the compressor connector. Now I will test the body short, if any, present in it. It does not show the body short with one of the wires but is short with the other wire, and the reading is 18.87 mega ohms. The compressor is considered good if the value exceeds 500 mega ohms or more. And if it shows no resistance value with the body, then it is considered as it will work. This is the reason it is not starting the compressor. The winding of the compressor has been shorted. Now I have got another surprise for you friends. I have taken off the protective cover from the top of the compressor. And see this, all the compressor wires have been burned and short-circuited with each other. As in the start, I told you this is possible. So we are seeing the same problem with this mini split as well. Let's clean this area, remove these wires, and hope it will be easy to fix. All the wires are badly damaged. Let's check this connector. It is getting harder to remove this connector from the compressor. Now I have a question about whether the compressor is fine or not. So I will check the compressor. First, I am installing the black probe. I will attach the second probe as well. The multimeter is showing 3.8 ohms reading. It is showing the reading okay. The next terminal is also showing 3.4 ohms. And now, I am connecting the probes on the last terminals of the compressor. It is showing 4.3 ohms. Let's check the body short as well. This means this compressor has a chance that it will work as it is not grounded with the body. I have cleaned the compressor terminals. I have attached the heat sink with the PCB board to check the compressor without any problem. I have temporarily attached these wires to the compressor terminal to test it. Let's switch on the electric supply. The PCB has started working. And see, the fan and the compressor has started. The unit has started to consume amperes. And I have fit the copper pipes with the unit to test it properly. And see, when the compressor and fan are running, the light blinking is stable. The current has increased. As it was causing this issue, some refrigerant was put into the air. Now it is low in the refrigerant. And as I will charge more refrigerant, this unit will be okay. So we got success in finding this surprising fault. Click on the left or right thumbnail on the screen to watch our next videos and subscribe. It's free. Thank you.